do.
No.
What? No, I was not taking a picture. Where is that picture? It's a video.
Welcome, my name is Captain John, that's Captain Al at the wheel. You guys excited? Alright guys, so now that we're all loaded up here, if you want to spread out, you can now that we're off the dock. There's plenty of extra room, we're not that busy today. A couple simple rules on board the Thundercat. You'll notice the high handrails that you see around the vessel. The stability of the vessel you don't see. Because of those factors, you are not required to wear life jackets. You have them on board for every soldier here for emergency. Our number one rule, do not stand on the sea. Does everybody hear me? What did I say?
Don't stand on the sea.
Do not stand on the sea. You could slip and fall out of the boat out there, and we have a really big problem. Also, when we're cruising, guys, we want you sitting down like this. When we slow down and we're just going slow, if I tell you it's okay, stand up, no problem. You can move around, take pictures, video. So we got some strong winds today out of the south, okay? South's not the best wind for us in this area. Most likely, we're going to go peak. You want to go look at it? We're going to take a peek at the inlet, but we're probably going to run you guys through the harbor and out to the Delaware Bay. Take a look out that way, all right? Be a little bit nicer ride. I don't want to get you too wet and banged up. Make sure that your hats are on nice and tight, all right? If you have a loose fitting hat, it'll lose it. The dolphins will be wearing it tomorrow, all right? But yeah, we're gonna go peek out the inlet, but most likely with that wind, we'll probably be going out through the canal. It's a nice ride through the canal. It just takes a little bit longer to get there, out to the bay. Who's been out with us before? Anybody? Anybody else, you guys? All right, welcome back. Ahead here, guys, is the harbor of Cape May. We'll be going probably by there shortly, home to the U.S. Coast Guard. Head up ahead on the left is the inlet. Take a peek out there.
Thank you. the wave start. Wave. Cut the wave. They like to steer into them.
Be careful, guys, or they come sit down. You don't want to be getting up while we're going out here, right?
I did too, but I thought I did too, but I'm not sure. mind.
We're just going to take it easy right around the point here. How's everybody doing? Got a little wet there, didn't you? It won't hurt you.
A little bit.
Now what happens, guys, is we'll be turning around and tipping New Jersey, and we'll have the land protecting us from the south wind. Over here, guys, you see the large concrete structure right there on the beach? Anybody know what that is? That's the foundations of my new condo. It actually has a name, that's called Battery 223. It was built by the military for World War II. Check this out, though. That thing is enormous. It has 20 rooms. The walls were built 3 foot thick of concrete. And when it was first built, it was underground. Yes, this used to be beach, guys. All the beach used to come way out, years and years of beach erosion. There used to be 3 large gun cannons on the surface over there. And they were always aimed out here in line with another bunker. That's Delaware right there, guys. The beaches of Delaware, about 16 miles, right? So we're going to be leaving the ocean, and we're going to be going into the Delaware Bay. It'll be a lot calmer for you guys. You see that beautiful lighthouse? Anybody been there before? The Cape Nobody? The Cape May Lighthouse? You did it? Pretty cool, isn't it? So guys, if you want to do it, just be aware. It's 199 steps. The top. There's no elevator. That one was built in 1859. The very first 2 lighthouses were both destroyed right here by very bad hurricanes. One in the late 1700s, one in the early 1800s. Looks like they're having a little school group out there. They must have all visited the lighthouse here long. You're looking at the very, very tip of New Jersey right there, guys. Yeah, if you have good eyeballs, you see the windmill out there? There's a windmill. That's where Hogan Beach, Delaware. Yeah, the tree line. Ocean City, Maryland. I'm a crab guy. I like to crab. 38 miles to the inlet from Ocean City, Maryland. Is anybody hungry besides me? Who wants to go to Philly and get a cheesesteak? Yeah, Philadelphia is around the corner, 65 miles. So you sort of now know where you are. Now that big building, guys, with the red roof, that is one of my favorite buildings. It's called St. Mary's by the Sea. Originally, it was built in the mid-1800s, known as the Shorehand Hotel. A young man from New York built it, and he had a lot of highfalutin friends who wanted to entertain. And he lost his mind drinking, and one day he donated to the church. It's a retreat home for the Catholic Church. Alright, guys, make sure you're sitting down. We're going to go around the tip of New Jersey. Again, this is Cape May Point. We're going to try to find you guys some dolphins up here at the bay. Alright, so everybody now look where it's been a spout. It's going to get much calmer, guys, as we go in here. where they are.
Thank you.
baby cat. There's two of them, right?
Thank you.
guys were fishing in a little boat over the weekend. See how I'm sitting? Yeah, right up the street, yeah, right up the road there. As they were coming in from fishing, they seen something in the water only 1 mile off the beach. That's close. A 13-foot great white shark. Came right up to the boat. Yeah. Yeah. That won't hurt you. As long as you stay in the boat. I don't swim in the ocean. I see what's out here. Alright guys, stand up everybody. We are in one of my most favorite parts of the island. This is called Sunset Beach. Sunset Beach is in front of you where the flag is. It's home to a shipwreck, guys. A well-known shipwreck. The locals gave it the nickname the Concrete Ship. Alright, Concrete Ship is world famous. Anybody know the real name? The SS Atlantis. She was built by the Navy for the Navy in 1918. World War I was about to happen. He built 12 ships like this because there was a massive shortage of steel and iron during the First War. This one was built with steel, rebar, and concrete. 12 of them. We lost 8 of them to German U-boats. They were a huge mistake, guys. They were too heavy, too slow. This one, 270 foot long when she was built. You're looking at a little piece of the stern, the back of the ship. SS Atlantis. Yeah, in 1926, guys, she got caught in a storm out here, and this is where she winded up here on Sunset Beach. What's crazy with me and our little kids just the other day, you could walk all over the ship. It was on the beach. This is beach erosion. Years and years of beach erosion. But you'll see there's not a whole lot of it left, but it's been here forever, guys. Does anybody know what we're famous here for at Sunset Beach? Anybody? Sunsets. Ah, come on, that's easy. This is the famous beach only here. People come for Cape May Diamonds. You heard of Cape May Diamonds, right? Yeah, this is where you find them. This is the wrong time, though. You want to do it during the low tide. See, the kids are looking. Cape May Diamonds are these beautiful little stones. They're all beautiful colors. Pink, purple, blue, orange, clear. And they make beautiful jewelry out of them. Alright, they came from the mountains of Pennsylvania thousands of years ago. They're quartz. And the sand over time and the storms polishes them up. And that building in there, you can buy a beautiful jewelry they make out of. Pretty cool. And tonight around 7 o'clock, we have a special ceremony at the flagpole. Every single night, 6 months out of the year, we will lower the flag and we will fold it up and give it to a family who lost a loved one during the military, a serviceman. That's a nice thing that we do here, okay, 6 months out of the year. All right, guys, we're gonna float around for a minute. This is nice and calm for you. Please listen up. We have Gatorade, Coke, Diet Coke, ginger ale, Sprite, iced tea, bottled water. And if you want to partake in our lunch buffet, guys, I was up cooking all night. Fritos, Cheetos, and Doritos. Popcorn, pretzels, potato chips, Oreo cookies, peanut butter crackers, all kinds of good, healthy stuff, guys. Sour Patch Candy, yes.
Whatever you want. You want anything? under the best I can.
Right there, right over here, Delaware, the beaches. You'll notice some of the large ferry boats when we're going by the terminals. It's about 16 to 17 miles from the canal over to Delaware, and Philadelphia, about 65 miles up the bay. So it's a big body of water. The bay used to be famous back in the early days for whaling. This was a big whaling area. This is how people used to survive in the wintertime, by whaling and fishing. After the whaling industry had ended, we were known here for oysters. Okay, on a normal day, back in the early years, up until the early 1900s, more than 1,000 men worked out in this bay a day getting oysters. And then we had some terrible things when they invented different chemicals for fertilizers. Things got into the water and it destroyed our oyster industry. It never really recovered. It's a very, very big body of water. Now it's mostly recreational fisheries and clams, oysters, stuff like that. Hey guys, let's run a little bit over the canal. There's one other area I want to look for before we make our way in. First, the wet people. You're starting to dry off a little bit. There's a couple dolphins in there feeding. Here, stand up. Look where I'm pointing. This is called the Cape May Canal. This is how we go home today. Yeah, they're sort of scattered in here feeding, guys. So this will be your last look at them. See here too, guys. Girls, look. Come here. Don't stretch in. Like, come here. Come on. Come on.
Come up there.
Sure, all right. There's a nice group, guys. Well over 20, maybe 30 right here. Some of them just swam under the boat too. Look behind you as well. They're not going to like do a pose for you guys, yeah. They're going to always keep moving. Sarah.
Hey guys.
Hello. Does anybody know where a dolphin sleeps at night? Anybody? In a waterbed. Come on. This is pretty cool, guys. Dolphins do not sleep. Ever. They cannot. They would. It wasn't that funny, was it? Wasn't that funny?
Good. All right. I don't notice anybody ever laugh.
He's like in a thumb him. So dolphins can't sleep, guys. They're too heavy. They're full. That's the hanky-panky going on over there. When they're belly to belly, they are mating, guys. They mate very aggressively. Yeah. Two sides to their brain. One side can rest, be shut down, while the other side keeps them breathing and swimming. They never ever sleep.
Oh, yeah. I did.
Way quicker, guys. It's an hour and 10 minutes to get across the bay to Delaware. And you don't have to bring your car. You can leave the car and go for a day trip. For you women that like shop, I guess men too, I'm not a shopper, but if you go shopping, it's called the Outlets in Rehoboth Beach. And they have shuttle buses, and they pick you up at the terminal, and you go around the town, have lunch, do shopping, things like that. We'll see that. The lobster house is at the heart of Cape May. I'll point it out to you. Remind you. What, you know lobster? What size? Down the street. Big one? Dolphin slice. I don't think that's happening. I see they're loaded up. They're ready to go. Each ferry takes about 100 cars. About 500 people. And they operate year-round. Guess what? If you don't have the ferry and you live here, you're going to drive all the way around Philadelphia and come back up.
I know, amazing, huh?
Ever heard of an osprey before? Fish hawks, yeah. You're gonna see a lot of them when they come out here. They like to build their nest, guys, up on the same up here. This one has a bunch of chicks in it. They always build their nest up on top there. There's another group behind them as well. Ospreys are fish hawks, one of the few birds in the world that solely relies on live fish. They won't eat a dead fish, gotta be alive. See him up there? There's little chicks under her. The osprey. this is called the West Cape May Bridge right here, guys. All right, this is mostly used local people. All right, you guys might get lost back here, but West Cape May Bridge. We're going to go through a narrow opening here. I'll tell you a short story about this. All right, this in front of you was owned and operated by Amtrak. We used to have a train. I was very, very popular. 1950s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. All right, it was called the Seashore Route. It was a passenger train, and you could board it in Camden, New Jersey, and then it would get off at First Street. All right, so the bridge itself is a big turnstile. The engineer would send a signal, and it would connect to the track. The problem we have with it now, us mariners, along with the county and state, are suing Amtrak. It is a hazard. It's a very dangerous area. This canal is like a river, and every 6 hours it changes direction. You see the water moving? Where do you think the water's coming from? The ocean. It comes from the inlet. All right, so this thing is constantly an obstruction. People get bad accidents here, boating accidents. It's a rust bucket. So hopefully they will remove it someday. Up on the left, this little neighborhood is called Tranquility. Was built about 20 years ago plus. Bridge that you would take to get on to the island of Cape May. This canal was man-made and dug out for World War II. Alright? Up ahead, Cape May Harbor. The harbor of Cape May. Somebody was asking me how to get to the lobster house. You go over the bridge. Big sign on the left, the lobster house. Yes. Over here, guys, this is called the Canyon Club Marina. There's a lot of sport fishing vessels and a lot of vacation condos. They usually have two big tournaments here every summer in July and August. first went out the inlet and you guys were a little bit goofy-eyed. You were getting a little nervous and wet. Right on the other side of those trees and those buildings, that is the beach of the Coast Guard base we went by. The inlet's right there. So we took you guys out the inlet, went along the Coast Guard beach, along the public beaches, all the way around Cape May Point, and we did a big giant circle. Circumnavigated the island. Because of the wind today, that was the most comfortable route. Poor osprey nest over here on the left. Again, they always make their nest right above the water.
All the way to the Gulf of Maine,
and the other direction. They will go from here all the way down to the Florida Keys, typically doing offshore inspections, commercial fishing vessels and whatnot, and making sure people who this are playing by the rules. And of course, they're always out there doing search and rescue. It's a very, very big base. Over here, guys, good spot for lunch, for happy hour, the Harbor View. Alright, that's where Captain Al hangs out at night. They've got good, simple food. I'll give you some clues. That's where the locals go. Alright, so if you want to grab some simple stuff, salads, soups, burgers, chicken wings, cold beers, margaritas, you can sit out on that big, big deck, which is enclosed. For nighttime, you can go upstairs, overlooking the harbor. Captain Fred built that about 20 years ago.
Thank you.
skipper, Captain Al. Great job, everybody. You guys have a good time? Most of you guys are dry by now, right? Yeah, that's where we started, out in the bouncy ocean there. And got you a little bit wet, coming all the way around. So we do the best that we can, considering the weather that we have. Keep us in mind, if you are here for a couple more days and the weather gets a little better, you might want to try parasailing. And Atlantic Parasail is here. And Wildwood Wave Runners, if you want to try renting a jet ski, parasailing, all the information up in the yellow building. But guys, when you get home from your little getaway, maybe you can help us out and do something nice for us. We would appreciate if you folks would do us a review, like TripAdvisor review, Google review, and also now we're doing that thing called Instagram. You know how to do that? I don't. So maybe you can share your pictures on Instagram and Facebook. All that stuff is out there. We appreciate it. Make sure, guys, that you're all sitting down. We're going to go up here and spin the Thundercat around. Keep your body parts on the side, please. And guys, as you make your way off, do not forget to say hello to our favorite dolphin. This dolphin, his name is Tippy. Yeah, lift his head up. We appreciate any kind of gratuity. And for you cashless people, don't worry, we got you covered. That new thing called Venmo is up here. I don't know how it works either, but we have one. All right, guys, again, thank you very much for coming out. We hope you enjoyed the ride.
You love it? Yeah, you love it? Oh, come on. Move the camera, please. Oh, my God. Love you all.